All right, Coach, under hazy, overcast L.A. skies, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Dignity Health Sports Park in Carson, California. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Jacksonville Jaguars and our home team. NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in week 11 on EA Sports. This will be taken to the back of the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Here's second and eight. He's got Smith here, and he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 11 yards there for Jacksonville at a first down as well. First down, Jaguars. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. Second and 11. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. That one, a pickup of 15 for Jacksonville.
Every coach we ever talk to says to his team before the game, quick start, guys. Let's get out of the gate fast. How about that? They took his lesson to heart, didn't they?
They did exactly that. A nice diving catch here on the game's opening drive. Boy, nowhere to go at all on that first down run as they will get to him behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down. So add that tackle for a loss to the two that he had a week ago.
And you know what he's doing right now?
Smiling?
Yeah, definitely doing that. But he's also patting his guys on the back, his defensive front, because they're keeping him clean, meaning no one's getting to him as a blocker. He's able to run to the football, and the plays he's making, he's spilling them in the offensive backfield.
The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. And he's already got two catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. Now he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one a pickup of 15 for Jacksonville. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. Here's a quick throw caught by Smith. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
That was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly.
Check back, check back.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 25. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Set. 50. Plant. Topper. Topper. Back. 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 Go.
They'll try the left side. Mooney, and he'll rumble for about five, up close to the 40. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. And again, this time to the tailback. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42.
70, Indy. Coaching spell. It's a game of three.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
Well, that was big right there because they're in the bottom five in the league in converting on third down. They needed that pickup in a big way.
There were two things they said they wanted to win in this game. One, the turnover battle, and the second, third down conversions. So they got one there. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger first down. Right back to him on first down. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Off the play fake. Herbert. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Josh Allen in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
And they're picking up right where they left off with the shutout that they pitched last week. A huge part of that, this pass rush. They know how to get after people.
Offensively, good luck finding some answers right now. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. So a false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long. Throw. Herbert. He's going to air one out. That's caught inside the 20. And that goes as a gain of 37 on third down. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Now left side on the swing pass. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive. They only got a yard out of that last completion. And that makes it second and nine. Second and nine now. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. From 17 yards out, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. You'd have to imagine for a team that's lost three straight games, scoring first in this first quarter has to feel pretty good.
That's feel great for them, and also it's a nice signal to the rest of the team, because we talk about complimentary football all the time. So they've now signaled to the defense, now signaled to the kicking game, hey, we're here to play in this one. We're going to do our part. Let's see if you guys will do the exact same, and we can break this losing streak.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight for.
Yeah, and wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff that they all made sure to let us know, we know where we are right now. But the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together, formulating a streak, got the whole month of December still left to play. They think they can get in.
And they made it very obvious to us that there's no playoff talk in the locker room right now. It's win this game and look to next week.
Excellent focus.
And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. 22 yards there, a first down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
They'll drop the throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jordan. That catch good for five. It's third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going. Defense right there. Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. Play-action fake. They'll look to throw. And this is caught that they say out of bounds. That would have been a first down, but he couldn't stay in. And as a result, they're going to have to give up the football. Well, I guess they wanted to get that touchdown right back on their first drive, but failed to do so.
And what they have to be careful of is pushing so hard to stay right there, to stay even with their opponent. That they gas themselves out. You know, it's almost like horse racing. Sometimes you don't want to take your horse right to the front and let them do all the work and then someone catch them at the end and pass them up. You want to make sure you moderate what you're doing along the way and then go for the big finish.
On first down, Herbert into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 44, and his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it. Not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he
up.
Trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much. And I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive because I've got the wild bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Now we'll see what his offense can do.
56, the mop boy. 56. Check 56.
They'll set up to throw. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. 22 yards there. A first down.
Well, partner, when you ask anyone other than your QB to throw the ball, you must have a lot of confidence or you think you're really going to fake them out. And it looks like they did exactly that.
Yeah, going deep in the playbook and a great grab on the other end.
Mike, 56, right there, 56. Hey, get up. Pick it up, D. Mike, 56.
Go!
Check back. Exit. Ready.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Complete. Smith has it. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Didn't they tell us in our meetings that they needed to account for him on each and every play?
You think a guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that wide open?
That usually means there's a tire breakdown on what the coverage was. Everyone thought they were doing something, and they're supposed to be doing something else. The bottom line is, no matter what, you have to know where he is and cover him on every play.
23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other bats in the league.
The Jags with their first opportunity in the red zone. They've got it first and goal at the 6.
He's coming.
They'll run here with Henderson. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of 1, and that'll bring up a 2nd and goal. At the 6-yard line. 2nd and 6. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Well-timed effort there by Derwin James. A sack from his safety position.
2nd goal. Last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. Had to eat it and ended up on the ground.
They need to reverse the trend. The last 2 plays have gone backwards. Now it's 3rd and goal.
56 the mark, boy. 56. Check 56.
He'll look to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now since it's 4th down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to 3. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. Now, that's something of a pick-me-up, and the offense certainly has struggled, but they do get the field goal before half to put 3 on the board.
Yeah, you don't want to be shut out, but let's face it, those 3 points, that's not going to solve all their problems either.
The Charger drive about to get going. And to be frank, they're just in a tough spot. It's only November, already eliminated from playoff contention. I know their fan base doesn't want to hear that, but that's the case. What are they fighting for now going forward?
You know exactly what they're fighting for. Is that word that some people don't want to hear? But it's pride.
I was going to go draft, but pride's better, right?
You know, something. You're right, because that's part of it. But that's 2 different mindsets. That's front office mindset, draft position. Where are we going to be? What do we need to get? And then the players and the coaching staff right now, pride. Can they win some games and feel better about themselves despite the fact they have no shot at the playoffs?
They'll run on 1st down. Mooney. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It's a loss of 1 yard there, and now 2nd down.
Don't forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he's able to hold on to the football.
Ready?
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Herbert. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 36. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll try the left side. Moving. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
No gain on the play. Second and 10 at the 35-yard line.
To throw on second down. Herbert, they'll try and set up the screen. It's complete.
Herbert's pass.
And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. That last catch winds up costing him three, so now they'll need to convert on third and 13. From the gun, Herbert. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one. Go to the locker room, start over.
Forced out to his left. Throw left side complete. It's Jordan. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. This will be taken in at the one. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you turn that because now I think they'll go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change the
touchdown. A great effort there. 78 yards. The Chargers, they're able to widen their lead. And those are the highlight reel runs you dream of right there.
When he gets a seam and just gets through it, how about the explosiveness, the burst to get there to begin with, and then once he's in full gallop, good luck trying to track him down.
And those plays so demoralizing for the defense.
Absolutely, because you've done so much work trying to keep people in front of you. When they're past you and behind you, that's a tough one to swallow.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
Chopper!
He'll come out throwing here on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jordan. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. That throw good for four. It's second down.
At the 29-yard line.
Second and six, just inside the 30.
Go! Under press.
General!
Check.
Looking to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 36. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And this is going to be a Charger touchdown. This D. put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive, and they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up, but you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
Good work after the catch. Going to net them 23 and a first. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And here we go again. Here we go again.
Now Taylor. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. Here's a second and seven. He'll find Taylor. That's complete. That second down play nets a minus four. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Back to throw here. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Joey Bosa in there to get him, and on the season now, that is nine sacks for him.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner, and I don't think, with three scores down in the third quarter, they can truly afford any more the rest of the way.
No, especially the way their offense is sputtering. I think you're exactly right. They got to find some answers quickly. The Charger drive about to get going. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
Looking to throw on second down. Herbert, his throw incomplete.
All right, that one fell incomplete there, but the best quarterbacks, they'll miss on 40% of their throws somewhere in that neighborhood, similar to a great hitter in baseball who's going to fail 7 out of 10 times and still have a great year. In this case, you want perfection, but way better than it hits the ground instead of going to an opposite color jersey.
And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Looking to throw. Herbert. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll get this way down into Jacksonville territory. It's a big one there for the Chargers. And even 50 yards. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. A 15-yard touchdown grab. The Chargers, they're able to widen their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half. not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side, because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars. On first down, it's Taylor. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
He'll drop to throw. Throw left side complete. It's Jordan. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now back to throw. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds, because they are very gifted. They'll make the surface catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Down to the 30 after a gain of 3.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. The 22 is the line to gain here on third down.
Go, go. Check. Motion out of the backfield. Motion out of the backfield. Yeah. 52 is the mic, boys. 52.
They're going to look to throw. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sack back at the 38. Joey Bosa has now recorded 10 sacks on the season. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And that is no good. He gave it a good run. That was a move and a foot or so wide to the left. Back now at Dignity Health Sports Park in Carson. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. The Charger drive about to get going. We find ourselves here in the midst of a one-sided affair. A lot of fill time down the stretch, Mr. Davis.
So we could talk about food, because that is...
There he goes, left side! And all the way in for a Charger touchdown! A big play there! His third touchdown of the game, number 11 on the year, as his guys continue to pour it on. I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is, his first miss, no good. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Fielded about a yard deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
Here we go, D. Cut up.
Off the play fake. He'll look to throw. Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. To throw here. And this one complete to Smith. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball, because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Let's go, D. It's going to be a long day offense. You go tight.
He'll look to throw. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. And the Jaguars send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. Pulled in at the 24. A great return there of 22 yards. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. The Charger drive about to get going. And Charles, we are in the midst of a very one-sided affair. I think this is where you and I have to fill a little bit. You want to regale us with old stories of your childhood in New Paltz, New York?
I don't think anyone wants to hear that, but this is a perfect time for us to start listing MVP candidates, right? These teams we've seen so far this year, the best games that we've called thus far, how we anticipate the season unfolding. Can go in so many different directions because the game certainly not taking us there.
Oh, I hear the remotes clicking off right now. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here.
Six guys.
Operating from the gun. Herbert. Going for a right side here. Complete. Give him 12 yards there. The Chargers have a first down. This quarterback now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. Back to throw. Herbert. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. A nice little screen. They get 6 on first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion. So here's 2nd and 4. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more. And again, this time to the tailback. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed 2, he got 1, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard.
Brings up 4th down and 1.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on 4th and 1.
Check 52.
Hard, hard.
Flare.
On 4th down, Herbert. This one caught right at the 6. Touchdown, Allen. As his guys are in for 6. As his guys continue to put this one out of reach. Trying to bust out of that losing funk, and these fans have to like this. And all right, fellas, this is more like it.
And I know that if this holds up after the game, they're going to give the fans a lot of credit being at home, getting the support. But you and I both know it goes deeper than that. They had to get it together in their own facility, look each other in the eye and say, okay, what's it going to take to break this losing streak? And they really came together with a good week of practice.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the 4th quarter of what has been a one-sided affair.
Let's go, let's go!
So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score.
Let's go. 56 to Mike. Hey, check 56. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. 56 to Mike. Let's go.
Back to throw now on first down. It's caught. Smith. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 23 yards on the play. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Mike's 56.
Pick it up.
Bravo.
Pick it up.
56 to Mike, boys. 56. Check 56.
Here we go.
56 is the mic. 56 is the mic.
They look to throw now on first down. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Derwin James with a pick. And they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. And that one, Charles, is just going to about wrap up what was no doubt a dominating defensive performance.
Yeah, I don't care what team it is. I don't care who you play, whether they're strong offensively or not. Just giving up 3 points in the NFL, that's absolutely a dominant performance and one that they can build on.
Chargers in good field position to start out first and 10 at their own 42.
Protein spill.
You better bring it. I'm letting you know right now, you better bring it.
Under 10, under 10, 10.
Hey, alert 48. Alert. Hey, we don't like the 48 right now.
Be driven, be driven.
That one looks like he'll throw here. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Josh Allen racking up sack number 12 for him on the year. Play action. Herbert, he shakes him off, shrugs him off. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Josh Allen racking up sack number 12 for him on the year. Throwing on third and long. Herbert, and he's taken down. Back at his own 7.
Brandon, more often than not, you'd say they've had his number, and we can count them up so far. 1, 2, 3, 4 sacks given up. But guess what? He's still been able to make some plays, and right now they have a lead.
The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game. Here's Matt Hawk now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And the punt goes out of bounds. Where will they put it? They'll put it just inside the 45-yard line.
At their own 41-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling again.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
Now a fake. fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
Derwin James on the cover.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three.
Watch 23.
Ready, go. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock. The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. Try to punch it in with Taylor. And he will have the first down as he gets the...